Welcome to the session of Master Stroke, and this Master Stroke is related to your DI. Especially, we are going to discuss in this session about one of the technique or one of the very good tools to solve the T2 based DI caselet. This T2 based DI caselet means set, subset, and Venn diagram. One of the technique that is very much useful that is called vertical line diagram. And when it will be applicable and how we will use this technique that we are going to discuss in this session. Then of course it is going to affect your DI and LR section. Then just we'll try to understand what is VLD and how we will able to use this one. VLD means vertical line diagram. Just to tell, type 2, it is based on the set, subset, and Venn diagram, that is categorization of the DI caselet. What is Venn diagram? Venn diagram generally we are representing in the 2D form, in the form of circle. If it is 2 variable, then like this we are presenting. If 3 variable, then this way. Or if it is 4 variable, then this way. Based on this representation, we are able to understand what is the common area, what is the overlap area, or what can be the maximum or minimum overlap area, or maybe single area also will be there. These all are the single area. You can say this is your single area, first, second, or otherwise you just use a standard notation that will be much helpful. This is A, B, C, this is X, Y, Z, this is W. And A, B, C, this is the area where only A, B, or C, or you can say you are just keep here A, B, C, means only one category is available, that is the area A, B, C, a small A, B, C. What is X, Y, Z? X, Y, Z is the area where two variables are overlapped, minimum two variables are overlapped. What is the W? W is the area where all three are overlapped, means three category will be possible. If you are just representing the three variable A, B, C, then three category will be there. One kind of area where only A, B, or C are present, means any one, then that is represented by a small A, B, C. In a small A, it will be only this variable will be present, a small b only this variable, and a small c this variable will be present. X, Y, Z, where two variable will be present, either AB, BC, or CA. W, where all three will be present. It is easy to understand how much overlap, how much variance. If number of variable is 4, then still we have little hope we will able to represent in form of 2D. And all type of overlap area like this will become only A, this will become only B, this is only C, this is only D. Similarly, we will able to find like this area will become all A, B, C, D. Means you can say it is a W, where A, B, C, D all will be present. Same way, this area will become all three, where all three are present. Remaining will become, this area will become where all two are present. You can just put, there is no issue. This is 2, 2, 2, and this is also 2, this is also 2, and this is will become 3, this will become 3, and this will become 3, this will become 3. Now issue is, we have to just try to find if number of variable is more than 4. Our interest is here VLD, vertical line diagram. If number of variable is more than 4, then how to represent in 2D diagram? That is one of the biggest problem. Like variable, if 2 you have, then 2 circle you can represent, 3, then 3 circle. If 4 is there, then based on the square representation you will able to represent. But if number of variable is more and equal to 4, then only one thing is there, we will able to use VLD, vertical line diagram. What is vertical line diagram? This is very simple. Conceptually it is very simple. Like this is circle where all your variable are represented in the area, like here it is spreaded in this area. Now we are just cutting this circle. Earlier it was represented in area, now it will be represented in perimeter. This will become perimeter, and these all variable will shift to the perimeter, means like this it will be represented on the length, not on the area. Means same variable in place of area we will able to represent in terms of length. Means overlap area, here earlier it used to tell, here we will tell overlap length. Means in terms of length we will able to represent it. Then it will be easy, and more than 4, 5, 6, any of number of the variable we will able to represent. Just we'll take one example that will make our task easy to understand, or you can say concept via problems. Then example here, total student in one of the college or one of the school, it is 100, where cricket playing student is 90, football 80, hockey 70, TT 60, soccer 50, after then volleyball 40, kabaddi 30, and again volleyball is your 10. Total 8 games are there, and where cricket is playing by 90 student, football 80, like this one is there. Now, if question is asking, just suppose maximum of either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just suppose maximum of 5 out of 8 game. Just one example. One type of question. Maximum of 3 out of 8 game. How to find? How to find? If we don't know the VLD technique, then it is very difficult. Very difficult in the sense, you have to just apply set theory formula. That will take first time, it will be much time consuming, and afterwards also maybe you will get accurate answer or not. That is also difficult, because set theory, you know, if you are just increasing the variable 3 itself, then A intersection B intersection C, if you will see the formula, that will become that much length. It will be complete one liner, one line and one and half line formula, one formula for 3 variables. If you are using for 8 variables, here total number of games, total type of games are 8, then how much big formula will be there, and what you will consider, what you will not consider, how much complicated calculation will be there. Then you can say for competitive exam, that is ruled out. We will not able to solve based on that method. Then we will apply some shortcut, some common sense technique, where we will able to get this answer very easily, and that is called VLD. We will just try to apply VLD. Find maximum number of a student who plays exactly 3 out of 8 games. How to find? By Venn diagram formula or set theory formula, it is so complicated and confusing. VLD, it will be very easy, accurate, and time saving. Just we'll try to understand. These 3 games you have to find out of 8. First three big number. First we'll take, this is cricket, hockey, cricket, football and hockey. That is 90, 80 and 70. If you want to find 3 out of, maximum 3 out of 8, then these first 3 line first will represent from same side. What is this one? This is just one square figure, or you can say it is a combination of 4 number lines. That number will be written, number line generally we are telling, then it will be horizontal number line. Here just we'll put number scale on the y axis, not x axis. Second thing, you can take the fourth quadrant side, or you can say you can put the number starting from 0 to 100. You can put reverse way also, means you can put here 0, 10, 20 and finally it will become 100. That is also possible, no issue. But only thing is there, in this case you have to just put the line from bottom. You have to start the line from bottom. Here better, first we'll take 0, we'll keep on increase to the bottom side, it will come to 100. And all the lines, it is a closed square. Just to tell here, one common confusion may be, like in this school, if total number of students is not 100, if it is 200 or if it is 450 or it is 229, then how will represent? Nothing, we will just index to 200. Just will index to 200. Like just suppose total number of students is 229, then just will index to 100 and make it 100x. 229, it is 100x. If you are making 100x, then what will happen? Value of x will become 2.29, that much only. Just you follow the normal procedure how to solve this question. Afterwards, what is your coming solution? You just multiply the value of x, that much only. Means we will index the value in terms of 100 for easy representation of line, because 0 to 100 it will categorize in terms of 100%. Then we will able to represent so many lines together without any disturbances. Then here cricket is 90, this we have represented like this. Football is 80 and hockey is 70. Okay. Now maximum common among all these 3. If you will just try to understand, it will come 70. Means this is the zone where all 3 are present. This is your cricket, this is your football, this is your hockey. Means 70 is minimum where all 3 are present. Now, apart from these 3 numbers, big number, remaining 5 numbers are there, that also we can represent in different way to increase this 70. Like this next number 60, we will just put from bottom. If we are putting from bottom, it will go up to here. Then what is, just to concentrate this zone, this is the zone. Like 0 to 70, already 3 is there. If it is increasing more than 3, that is not our scope. We will just look the area where 3 was not there. 70 to 80. 70 to 80, this area, earlier it was only 2 lines. Earlier it was only 2 lines, this one and this one. Now what happened? Once you put this TT 60 from bottom side, this one, then what will happen? This 10 also will be added, or you can say this area, it will become 3 lines, 1, 2, 3. Means this you will able to add. Means this is the region where exactly 3 games are present. Then next will come like the region where only one line was present, like 80 to 90. Earlier it was only one line. Once you put the TT and next you are putting the soccer like this one 50, then you are getting the 3 lines, 1, 2, 3. If you are getting more than 3, that is not a issue. If you are getting more than 3, that is not a issue. Then this 10 you will able to add here. Next, this 90 to 100, these 3. Then this is again 10. Total, it is coming 100. More than 100 is not possible, because maximum is 100% only we can take. Then here, this question, 3 out of 8, how many maximum a student? What is the question? This question is, just we have to find maximum number of a student who plays exactly 3 out of 8 games. Then what will you answer? Maximum student will be 100. 100 out of 100 will play 3 games or maybe more than 3 games. But just this question will become further interesting if we are putting in place of maximum, it is minimum. Then minimum what will be there? We have to minimize the overlap. Means all the alternate lines we have to put from opposite side. Like here cricket, football and hockey we have put from the same side to increase the overlap. Because we have to maximize the number. We have to maximize the number. Just suppose we have to minimize the number, then cricket will put from top, football will put from bottom. Then what will happen? Overlap will become minimized. Then this type of many of the concepts are there related to VLD, vertical line diagram. And this is one of the very, very important tool for your DI. It is widely used for solving the CAT, mock CAT, or so many MBA entrance test level of questions. And it is really, really helpful. It is not only limited to one type of question. You will be able to apply variety of questions. And I will show in various type of caselet how it will be very helpful. Because this technique is very easy, very accurate, and very much time saving. Then I will just recommend you just try to adopt this new technique that is developed by me, and you will able to get the confidence also, and you will able to save a lot of time. Continue to learn, like so many technique related to DI, LR or quant, or maybe verbal also. Just to log into www.parolikho.com, or you can download the mobile app also. Thank you.